We're also visiting with not only alumni of the team, but alumni of the faculty.
That's
during
right.
the team. Don McEwen. And Don, 62, what was your role at Ann Arbor High School?
62. I was just starting that fall as a class advisor for the class of 65. And I just finished teaching. I'd been a co-op coordinator where the kids had worked for their jobs 15 hours a week and did that for a couple of years. And then Mr. Schreiber, Nick, asked me to become a class advisor, and so I did that. I was coaching girls track and boys track and cross country, and I loved doing that too.
Well, Don would be too modest to tell you, so I'm going to. He's a two-time NCAA champion. What event?
2 mile.
2 mile.
Yeah.
And back-to-back, right?
Yeah, sophomore and junior year. They moved to the 5,000 in my senior year, and I didn't want to run that one. That was a little too far.
you only won it twice. I mean, my goodness, what more can you say? And Don is very active in the community. He's part of Kiwanis. And actually, you stay pretty much in touch with a lot of your former students, don't you?
Yeah, I go to a lot of reunions and see my old people that are getting older. And I'm glad to say that I'm in the same boat.
Any one or two moments in your teaching career that stand above any other?
No, I'd say most of them were good. I loved doing what I did, and I enjoyed it, and I think I did okay. So I'm very happy that I changed from selling oil for the Shell Oil Company to becoming a teacher and a coach.
And he's a very proud Canadian, I might add. Yes. Thank you, Don. Here's another special guest, Mike Kohler. Mike is a member of the greatest fraternity in the United States today, the Theta Chi fraternity. The Theta Chi.
We are.
Yes.
Yeah, well, we are.
Okay.
Aztecs.
Okay. Now we got that clarified. You're here representing your brother. So tell us about him, what he's doing, etc.
Sure. He lives in Holland, the country, now, and he retired from being he owned an advertising firm in and around Chicago, basically around the Northwestern University area. And on that team, he played left halfback, and that's pretty much it. I was on the team the year before that, and kind of set the table for these guys.
The best story, we're talking about Pat Kohler, by the way. One of the best stories is the year before, your senior year, his sophomore year, he gets brought up to the varsity for the last game, and you pick up the story from there.
Yeah, sure. It was unusual back in those days for sophomores to even get in the game, even the last game. But we were thumping Jackson pretty badly, so they put him in. I happened to notice he was in the huddle. They called his signal. He went over my hole for a touchdown. He was an accomplished gymnast, and in the course of celebrating, one of his cleats caught my eye. There was blood, there were stitches, and it was my last play in high school.
Something to remember your brother by and something to remember your high school career by.
I have photographic proof, yeah.
Well, it's nice that you came here tonight, and I'm sure you see a lot of familiar faces.
Oh, yeah, it's surprising how familiar many of them are, even a majority.
And they don't look any older than you remember them either.
Not a day.
And where are you now?
I'm in Dexter.
Rick Dienhofer on the 62 squad, and tell us about your career here at Pioneer.
Well, I wasn't one of the first line guys, but I did get a chance to play a number of times depending on the game, but it was a fantastic experience, fantastic coaches, and fantastic players all around. It was, really enjoyed it.
Anything about that season you remember in particular above any other?
I did make one touchdown, but it wasn't during a game. It was during a scrimmage here on our own field.
Hey, been there, done that. I tell you, I was a marginal player. Some of my best games were on Thursday night under the lights here. Now, you were on the kickoff team. I bet you had some highlights there.
Yeah. You just run down and try to get the guy with the ball. You know, I mean, that's about all there is to it.
You didn't have one returned on you, did you?
No, sir. No.
And okay, and so tell us what you're doing now, where you live.
I'm retired. I graduated from high school, went to Eastern a couple years. Then I dropped out of the college, and but I knew I needed to get some kind of a work skill. So I ended up getting into an electrical apprenticeship and worked as an industrial electrician for over 30 years between Hoover Ball Bearing in Ann Arbor and then also the GM plant, Willow Run plant.
And where do you reside now?
We live in Munith, Michigan. It's just south of Stockbridge, small community.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you direct your attention to the center of the field for tonight's coin toss. Among other wonderful things happening tonight at homecoming is the 50th reunion of the 1962 championship Ann Arbor football team. Tonight, Harold Simons and Chuck Menefee are representing the 62-6A football championship team. 42 returning players are here. Exactly 50 years to the night when they defeated Lansing Sexton, the 1961 state champions, finishing a perfect 8-0 on the season. In 1987, this team, same team, gathered for their 25th reunion, and they were called the original Cardiac Kids by the Ann Arbor News. Congratulations, 1962. And we welcome you back.
We welcome you to this football game between Pioneer High School and Monroe High School, and now we proudly present the Pride of Pioneer.
Thank you. Since I was a young boy, I've been the shooting
guard. Here they are, your 2012 Pioneer Varsity Football Team!
Okay, we have two of the real stalwarts of that 62 team. Gentlemen, give us your name, rank, and serial number here.
Harold Simons, defensive halfback on the state championship team. I was a junior at that time.
Didn't you have a couple interceptions that season?
A couple interceptions that season and the season after, and a touchdown run back, and did my responsibility. That's why Coach Stilstroff had me out there.
Harold is truly one of the great athletes in Ann Arbor High School history. Roy, tell us about your background, etc.
Roy Campbell. I played defensive linebacker and fullback, class of '62.
Now, you were a tremendous running back, were you? I mean, I know you're going to be modest, but weren't you a great running back? Come on, tell us.
Well, they say I was, but as always, it's just having a lot of fun.
I'm retired from the Ann Arbor Public Schools, coaching basketball 30 years in the area and golf for 25 years, and doing a little part-time work and enjoying retirement.
I'm a carpenter by trade, and we work for myself, and retired, but not retired, still working a little bit.
So, you live in Ann Arbor?
Yeah, I live in Ann Arbor, yeah.
Here's one of the main cogs in that wheel of 1962, Chuck Menifee. Chuck, you're the starting quarterback. I'd like to have you just briefly summarize the last few minutes of that Battle Creek game when you guys were on offense.
Well, it started with a punt, and Jerry Hartman picked it up. Probably no one remembers this. It bounced high in the air. He had to go up in the air to bring it down, but it saved us starting 30 yards back down the field. And you know, he didn't gain much after he got it, but we got the ball about midfield and ran a few keepers, and time's running out. We get down at the end, around the 2 or 3 yard line, I think we scored a winning touchdown. But
now, Kent Leslie told us earlier, I don't know if you remember this, that you had tried to pass to him, and two defensive backs had collided with him, and he thought he broke his arm. And he said he came back to the huddle and said, whatever you call, don't call me. And you remember that?
Yeah, Jay probably told him to go out there and hit somebody. Yes, I remember that well now. And but even on the last play, the winning touchdown, I think there was 14 seconds left, I dropped the snap.
Oh.
And it came right back into my hands.
Oh.
And just took off with it, but got out around there and really I could have walked in with it. But Kenny Dyer was standing out there in the end zone all alone. I thought it was time he had a touchdown.
Oh, that was great. Well, Ken said that the down that you tried to pass to him, he talked to you later and you said, Kent, I just hoped you were there when I threw the ball.
Well, you know, we had really good timing. We knew where everybody was all the time.
But, you know, ice blood in your veins. I mean, come on, jeepers. You must have been extremely nervous.
No.
You weren't?
No, we're just playing football. And they, that never even crossed my mind. Huh. Got the ball, let's go.
Yeah.
Do what we can. So. Yeah.
Well, that's the confidence you had in the team and in yourself. So tell us what you're doing now.
Well, I live up in Harbor Springs, and I'm kind of retired, semi-retired. My brother's up around that area, and I was in golf business for a lot of years.
So you don't really have an occasion to come down here very often?
Well, yeah, I've been down in the last few years. I've come to games, and I never forget Pie High.
Right. Well, we'll never forget you, that's for sure. We have two members of the 62 team. Chuck, come here, Chuck Wilkins. And I want you, in all due modesty, I want you to tell us how you got Gary to reunion today.
We were pleased to have him come. We talked to him last night, and he said I wouldn't miss it. And he was a great part of this team. So we're delighted to have him here.
And didn't you go get him?
Ray Pittman did. And we're delighted he did, because it wouldn't be the same without him. So,
Gary, how do you feel being here? Are you overjoyed to be here?
Yeah, I've enjoyed very much. See the old guys, the young guys, and talk about their highs and lows and some things that you forgot that somebody's reminded you of. You go, no, I didn't say that. I didn't do that.
Well, tell us about what were the highlights for you personally of that season?
Well, it was pretty terrific. I really can't explain to you how special it was, but it was great every game. It was great to look forward to every game, and I had the great pleasure of playing right next to this guy, and between the two of us, we made some tackles.
Well, I want to tell you about Chuck Wilkins. Every time I've seen him, from youth to adulthood, he's always had some sort of affliction that he's having to deal with, and that year, tell us, you had a back problem that you're trying to correct.
Yeah, like everybody, you play a little dinged up, but it was a great season, and I'm really thankful that I got a chance to play with a bunch of great guys.
And I was telling Gary, I remember one game, he had been flagged by the officials, and it was get even time with the opponent across the line from him, and Gary gave him one shiver that I still think he's feeling. You remember that, Gary?
No, that's one of those incidents somebody reminds you of.
You were too nice to do something like that, right?
Yeah. But it's a contact sport.
That's what is Bob Ufer used to say, 60 minutes of man's inhumanity to man. That's pretty much what football is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Good luck to you guys. Michael Thomas was on that 62 squad. Michael, tell us what your role was.
I'm a right halfback. I was right halfback, offense and defense.
And what do you remember the most about that season? Anything in particular?
I remember that we played some good teams. We had some good games, some tough ones, you know.
And didn't you have one kind of moment in the sun? I can't remember. Jay was talking about it earlier. One of the games you made a very critical play, didn't you?
Yeah. We were playing Battle Creek, I think he's talking about. I made an interception, ran a touchdown.
And ran back for a touchdown?
Yeah.
Good man.
Yeah.
Good man. And that was a critical game. Now, tell us what you're doing these days.
I'm an artist, and I work in various mediums. I'm a wire weaver and a sculptor, one of the things I do. But I'm also a poet, and painting and drawing. I'm multimedia.
And where do you reside? Where do you live?
Fort Bragg, California.
Fort Bragg, California.
Mendocino, California.
Mendocino, okay. I never heard of that.
Yeah.
And you came all the way here from there.
Yeah, the guys on the team pitched the money in and sent for me, and I sure was grateful to get here.
Oh,
it's such a beautiful thing.
Chuck Holtz is our guest, and he has to be brilliant. He went to Slauson and Ann Arbor High School.
And Central Michigan University.
Oh, yes. That's right.
So Fire up chips.
Fire up chips, yes, sir.
Tell us about the 62 season, Chuck. What was your role and what do you remember the most?
Well, I just was a member of the team that we were all just teammates, and we pushed for one another and pulled for one another, and we just didn't let anything get us down. We never thought we could lose, and consequently, we didn't. And it's been indelibly etched in my mind about that. And you know, I coached football for 27 years, and I had three undefeated regular season teams, and nothing in my coaching career ever equaled 1962. It's just a special group of guys, and we're brothers.
What position did you play on that team?
I was an offensive and defensive tackle, and that was it.
I want you to tell these folks the following year your story about playing against Battle Creek Central and their all-state tailback.
Jesse Fleming, yep. Battle Creek Central used to like to trap, and I knew that, and they ran a trap play, and being the Einstein that I am, I didn't do my job, and the guard went by me, and I looked up, and there was Jesse Fleming, and the next thing I knew, I was picking myself up off the ground, and I looked around, and he was running for a touchdown. So that's my story about Jesse Fleming.
And Chuck had cleat marks right down the middle of his forehead.
Not just my forehead, but my stomach.
Well, that was then. You had a great career here, Chuck, and not only here, but coaching as well.
Yes, thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be back here, and I'd like to thank everybody that came back and all the people that honored us. It's humbling. And now I run a sport management business. We represent American football players that want to go over to Europe to play American football. And we have under contract now, we have 8 players, 5 of whom played last year in Europe. And we're HSH Sports Consulting, and we're having a good time. My wife and I live in Whitehall. It's on the west side of the state, about 12 miles north of Muskegon, right on Lake Michigan and White Lake. I get up every morning and I look out the window and I see White Lake. And it's just beautiful. I encourage anybody to come to Whitehall and visit me.
Well, lo and behold, look who it is. I want to, by the way, my friend Dale Leslie, who did a marvelous job of interviewing everybody earlier. But I'm here for a good time, and who I run into, well, my old friend Bill Bailey, right. Won't you come home? And you did.
Huh? That's right.
This you know, you're the third Bill Bailey that I know.
Oh, I am.
There's a white Bill Bailey in Chicago at WLS.
I got it.
And Louisville Radio. A black Bill Bailey at WLS, also in Chicago, and in Grand Rapids, where he still is.
I got
And you're
it.
The other white Bill Bailey.
Well, I'm down in the South Coast.
And this,
so we got it covered from that's Chicago right. All the way to
And you came
Gulf.
From Texas, right?
Yes, came up from Houston, Texas. That's right.
Yeah,
and,
well.
So we always enjoy coming back, and it's good to participate in the hospitality that's shown by the Booster Club and everyone else involved. And I see that one of the players has my old number.
Oh, I hope he's doing well tonight.
Well, that means my number wasn't retired.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, you'll be back here in a couple of years, I suppose, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll be 50th back. High school reunion.
Yeah, exactly.
Which I unfortunately I had a wedding to shoot on our 40th, I missed. I was there for the Friday night thing, but the big affair on Saturday I missed. So I've had to wait 10 years now.
Well, we always enjoy having Mr. Radio there at all the events.
I try. I try. So everything's good in Texas? You're
outstanding.
Still working?
No, I'm retired.
And your wife Louise was a teacher, wasn't she?
Yes, she was. She's retired now.
She hung it up too. Enough of these kids.
Yeah. And so my son has finished his tour of duty in the Army.
Oh, okay.
And so he's returned to Houston now as well. Oh. So
so the whole gang is together again.
Yes, it is.
Well, welcome aboard. I'm glad we can be here for this big reunion of the 62 season.
Yes.
Championship season at Ann Arbor High School.
Well, wouldn't have missed it for the world.
That was the year I moved here.
Thanks, Art.
All righty, buddy. Take care. All thanks, right, Bill. Bye-bye. Hi, it is Art Volo, and I want to thank my friend Dale R. for Radio Leslie, and he did a marvelous job here of interviewing all the various people that were at this reunion, or as many as would come on the camera, and then we just realized here at the end of our evening here that while the game is still definitely going on here at Pioneer High School, and fortunately down 13-9 at the present time, but I'm sure they'll come back. But we wanted to make sure that we had the two of the people who were very instrumental in putting this together, and that would be John White and Ray Pittman. John, how's it going?
Well, it's been a great event, and we had a great number of people show up. Some people flew in as far away as California, Maryland, Florida, Texas, and Nevada. So a lot of people came from a long way away to be here, and a lot of these people hadn't seen each other for 50 years.
That's a long time. And now you came all the way actually from Florida.
I did, and the weather here is not as nice.
Especially,
I may be going right back.
Yeah, well, it's a... The night we did this, by the way, it was a little bit, how do we say, cold and clammy.
We would certainly say that with a hint of precipitation.
Yes, more than a hint at times. Ray, you were a very big part of this, and tell us what you did in helping to organize.
Well, we have a Pioneer football alumni group here in Ann Arbor, and starting with the 1959 team, we have been sponsoring a luncheon at their 50th reunion weekend. And so we've done 59, 60, we just did 61, which was my team this summer. And we were very pleased to help sponsor this event for the 1962 team, which won that very coveted state football championship. We were the woulda, shouldas, all right?
Well, you did a heck of a job. So you're Mr. Reunion, right?
Yeah, I'm getting pretty used to it.
Well, I put together 4 radio reunions in Detroit, so I know it's a lot of work, and my hat's off to you. Where are you living these days?
Well, I live just down the road in Allen Park. Of course, we all grew up in Ann Arbor, the Whites and the Pittmans. Our parents were good friends.
My father was his dentist. Look at his teeth.
Yeah, wow. Well, anyway, and John, you divide your time between Michigan and Florida. Where in Michigan, where in Florida?
Florida, Sarasota, and in Michigan, it's called Shelby Township, just north of Detroit.
Yeah, know it well. Well, listen, guys, we enjoyed putting this together, and we hope that you have enjoyed seeing some of the highlights here of the 1962, 63, 64. How many years are we covering here?
We're covering 50 years from the 1962 season,
which
was our 50-year reunion for that championship season.
Wow, that's fantastic. Absolutely fantastic.
Well, we all look the same.
Yeah. Thanks to Art Volo for insisting that we do this. This would be a great ad.
Let's go Pioneers.
Let's go Pioneers.
Let's go Pioneers.
You've got 60 minutes of football and a lifetime to remember.